Now they are moving from one place to another, and we are in the city of Lystra now, verse 8. And there sat a certain man at Lystra, impotent in his feet, being a cripple from his mother's womb, who never had walked. The same heard Paul speak, who steadfastly beholding him and perceiving that he had faith to be healed, said with a loud voice, "Stand upright on thy feet." And he leaped and walked. And when the people saw what Paul had done, they lifted up their voices, saying in the speech of Lycaonia, "The gods are come down to us in the likeness of man." Now, do you notice the reception of Paul and Barnabas, and also the reaction to them? Now, first of all, let me say that Paul and Barnabas, they had the gifts of an apostle. They were the sign gifts. They came into these places. They had no New Testament. All they had was a message of the gospel. And as you can see, they had difficulty in getting this message received. And so they were given these gifts. Now, they were needed then. They're not needed today. The church has been established for 1,900 years. The Word of God is in our midst today. And it's what's in the Word of God, and it's not what men do today. If we could only get people to do that. I played golf down in the desert with a man. They had me, I think, play with him purposely. He's a very affable man, and a very generous man, very big-hearted man, but he's unsaved. A man who very candidly, very openly told me that he was chasing around. And I attempted to talk with him about the gospel. He knew the facts of the gospel as well as I do. And did you know something else? He believed them. He said, "I believe Jesus died." And he said, "I believe if I'd trust him, he'd save me." He said, "I believe that." Well, I said, "Why don't you do it?" And then he began to mention to me certain men whose lives, you see, didn't measure up. And I said to him, "For goodness sakes, get your eyes off of man." I said, in the first century, they performed miracles, and men got their eyes on them, and they had to take them off of them and get them on the book. I said, "Get your eyes on the Word of God and what God says today. That's the thing that's important, and after all, it's a personal relationship between you and God. And these third parties you're mentioning won't even enter into it when you stand before Him someday. The question will be your personal relationship to Jesus Christ as revealed in the Word of God. Go to the Word of God." Well, I'll be very frank with you. I didn't get very far with him, but I gave him a new approach. He said he'd never heard it that way before, and he said he thought maybe he'd try that. And I said, "Well, don't look at Christians. They all have feet of clay." And I said, that is the real problem. These men are looking now to Paul and Barnabas, and notice what they did. When they healed this man, the man had faith. He trusted Paul and Barnabas. They're pagan heathen people in that area, you see. And Paul said, "Stand upright on thy feet." And he leaped and walked. And when the people saw what Paul had done, they lifted up their voices, saying in the speech of Lycaonia, "The gods are come down to us in the likeness of man." Now, they are really pagans, aren't they? They are pagans. But notice how fickle they are. They call Barnabas Jupiter and Paul Mercurius, or Mercury, because he was the chief speaker. Now, you see, Paul is definitely taking the lead. Here they are. They want to make them gods. They bring garlands to put around their necks, on their heads, and now they're ready to worship them. Fickle? Does that remind you of anybody else? In America, one year, it'll be this baseball player, that football player, this politician, that politician. But next year, they are forgotten in somebody else that's new. And preachers are treated that way also. My, you can preach the Word of God. They say, "My, it's wonderful." One day, next day, they want to crucify you. Look what's happened now to